acknowledge me. So long, I love all. My enforcer, Jacob Fatu, step up.
Yeah, Jacob. Woo!
Man. Acknowledge me. Solo, I love you. My Lord Lama Solo, I acknowledge you. Wise man, look at me when I'm talking to you.
No!
Acknowledge me as your tribal chief.
Woo!
tables!
Thank you. WWE has changed in the last year or so. But one of the things that's always going to be the case, this is an absolutely wonderful team and wonderful crew who gets the ability to walk into the world's most famous arena. So WWE has a member of its family that's leaving. And I think the best thing that we could possibly do right here and right now is give them an MSG send-off. Ladies and gentlemen, you have been wonderful all night. You have been loud, you have been proud. Please, let's hear it for Kayla Braxton. To do here tonight. I mentioned it earlier when we came out here. I had a different plan in mind for my return to the garden. Because it is not just my return to the garden. For those of you who know the story, this is where it all began. In the late 70s, my father, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, traveled to New York City to wrestle superstar Billy Graham. He's a country boy from Austin, Texas, and for some reason, you guys just loved him. But anyways, in this fabled match, Dusty superstar Billy Graham. He grabbed what would become this WWE Championship. He climbed that buckle over there and he held it up. But moments later, they took it away from him. It's okay. This story has a happy ending. I was 8 years old, I saw the picture of him holding this title. I knew nothing about the ins and outs of pro wrestling and sports entertainment. All I knew was I wanted to win that title for him. And I had always planned on saying the silliest thing to him, but I just wanted to tell him that nobody can take it away from you now. So like I said, if you'll indulge me, I am going to climb that buckle because I want to hold up the WWE Championship. But if I could, my cousin Berkeley, you got something in your hands over there? I will trade you